I had the fortune of meeting Madeline Miller way back in 2013, and I would always remember her as someone who was very down to earth, pleasant, and would take time to listen to you and answer your questions. I have to admit that I did have a tiny little crush on her when I first met her. I had asked her that when it came to literature, why was it that tragedy always got the acclaim and comedy was never identified like that? She smiled. And then she said that that's a good question and she doesn't really know the answer to that. But what she can right now think of is that maybe it is tragedy that helps us to deal with the hard times. And that's something as humans we all need. And to deal with happy times, we don't really need to learn anything. And that's why this acclaim comes into the picture. I found her answer largely satisfying. I finished reading Circe a few days back, and this gorgeous golden book is an absolute treat to read. I was reading it and I was at a loss for how much should I mark and how much should I note in this book, because it was page after page that I was coming across amazing ideas and amazing lines and amazing thoughts. It was quite mind-boggling. It's the story of Circe, a mythological Greek character who is believed to be the first witch, and I found this book largely satisfying to read. We all interpret the stories and the books that we read differently. I'm sure if you pick up this book, your interpretation might be different as well. But for me, this book was largely a comment on how rulers who are presented as gods in this particular story, because it is based on Greek mythology and the characters from Greek mythology, how they have time and again used monsters and other dangers and ills and have thrown them on their subjects and societies so that they can remain in power by making people believe that they are the only ones who can save them and they are their only hope against those monsters and evils. This particular idea was quite interesting because gods and monsters are considered to be the opposite of each other, and here they were so closely linked and having a symbiotic relationship with each other, and one was actually the reason of giving birth to the other. And they themselves did not seem to be enemies of each other. It was just that monsters were essentially a threat to the people and the subjects, and gods wanted those monsters to be planted there so that they can come and save their subjects and remain in power. We have come across this theme a lot of times. We have seen so many movies and so many TV shows in which we see corrupt politicians supporting the mafia, supporting the terrorists so that they can come out and they can tell people that they are the only ones who can save them and hence remain in power. This is something which is not new, but what shook me while reading this book was that in this book, gods were shown as the ones doing this. Now, this religion is long dead, so it becomes very easy for anyone to write about it as freely as this book is written, because there are not really any people who are going to come out and say that we're going to kill you because you presented our gods this way. But still, I think it is a very bold statement to make, and it's a very bold attempt at presenting this story. The book does become a little repetitive towards the middle of it, but for this particular book, I would say that when you are dealing with a subject which is linked to something as diverse as the Greek mythology, it becomes very difficult to chop out things and to cut off the connections that the story might have. Like if I pick up a character from Mahabharata and if I start detailing a story about it, I will have to paint a picture about everything around that character to actually give it the kind of weight that it deserves. So that's why I didn't mind the book becoming a little repetitive towards the middle, but the ending was largely satisfying, and this is one book which I would definitely strongly recommend, and you should definitely give it a try and see how you like it. I have just started reading Jeff Vandermeer's Dead Astronauts, and I'm also reading Wuthering Heights, so I'll be discussing those two books very soon. And if you want to join me to read these two books, you are more than welcome. I want to have good, rich discussions about the stories and the books that I'm reading with you guys. If you have already read this book, I would love to have your comments. If you liked this book, if you didn't like this book, if there was a part which you didn't like and you didn't agree with, what was your interpretation of this whole story? I hope you guys are doing good. See you soon. Cheers.